That's it. We just got to get on the phone. Hey, Matthew, good to see you.
Yeah. You know, the question to ask ourselves is, why are we so reluctant to get on the phone, to get on face to face on Zoom? Why do so many people don't turn on the camera and stuff like that? How come we don't want to interact like the good old days, maybe? How come we don't want to do? We all want to. What is it the gurus all say? We got it. You got to automate your business. Okay. Why do we love automation? How come the only way I can communicate with my kids is to text them? Because they won't answer the phone. How many people here have kids and they don't answer the phone? Right? How many of our prospects don't answer the phone either? How do we interact with people? So you see, you got to be great on the phone. You got to learn to speak spontaneously with people. And you've got to also learn to change your marketing too, to attract more people into your more warm calls into your world.
One of my problems I have, and I remember when I bought your first book that I ever bought, you called me on FaceTime pretty much the second the order went through. And I kind of was expecting it. I recognized the number, I think, and I answered, but I always call people on FaceTime and 9 out of 10 will not pick up.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, how do you get people to answer?
Yeah, you know, you have to create they either have to know you, okay? They have to know you ahead of time. It's like if Brent Bowers, hey Martin Ramirez, if Brent Bowers calls you up and you see his name on the phone, are you going to answer?
Owe him some money or not,
You're paid off, Martin. You're paid
Yeah.
off. I don't think you owe me any money. I could be wrong, actually.
You can answer because you know him, right? If it's a stranger, we see call blocked, or we see some crazy bunch of numbers from a third world country or something, we're going to let it go to voicemail a lot of times. So a lot of times I put out a lot of, Brent does this too. He does his podcast. We put out a lot of content so we attract people. And I don't know if we have time to talk about that today. The other thing is,
How do we attract the money, or how do we attract land deals?
I'm looking to buy a property today. Something where they know you're a serious buyer. I have excellent credit. I'm ready to buy your land today. Call me before 2:30. I leave messages like I'll go on to Zillow. If we see an ad on Zillow for some land and it looks like nice land, and we know we can persuade, we have the gut sales method, three levels, and we want to talk to this person. What kind of voicemail do most people leave? Okay, hi, I saw your ad on Zillow. Give me a call when you get a chance. Here's my number. Okay, boom. And what's the percentage of people who call you back? Minuscule. But if you leave something we call a pattern interrupt. Okay, a pattern interrupt is where we're changing the environment, changing the standards. Okay, so John Willingham, if you get a phone call, hi John, I just spoke to the attorney. I got the paperwork and everything in front of me. I need to speak with you as soon as possible, buddy, before 2:30. 619-206-5960. Click. That's on your voicemail, and you've never heard from you never we've never spoken before. What are you going to do if you get that message, John?
Call him back and ask what
Yeah, come on, role play.
that
Hello,
what
Diamond
that's about.
Consulting Group. This is Claude.
Hi, what kind of contract are you talking about? The title company?
I'm sorry, who is this?
John Willingham.
Yeah, John, I'm sorry, John. This isn't about real estate, is it? I'm all confused. I took a stupid pill today.
I don't know, you left a message.
You don't have a problem. Yeah, I'm sorry. I leave so many messages. I can't keep them straight. You don't have that problem, do you?
I do.
You don't have any. This most people call me. Even Christopher Arnold call me because they have land or a house for sale. That isn't what we're talking about, is it?
Maybe I've got a property in Florida and I'm closing on some in Texas too.
Oh,
Are you
okay.
interested in those?
Yeah, would you like to sell it today?
Sure.
Boom. Are we off the role play? Are we in a conversation?
Yeah.
Definitely.
What did I do to get you to react to A? If you call me back, I win. And then What do I do? I apologize. I'm sorry. I forgot. So many calls and everything. And boom, I slid into a conversation with you. Do I have a shot? If I'm talking to you on the phone, do I have a shot, John?
Definitely.
I got a chance, man. But if we're doing this bullshit texting and emailing and everything else, what's the algorithms? What's more in my favor? A direct communication with you or all the other stuff?
And video
Direct.
is even better because then you have their best behavior. You know, they're not messing around. You know, they're focused on you. And by the way, I don't know if you're on, Claude, when I said I had just got off the phone with a coach that's going to help me with my cold callers and to get more land deals. Christopher's it. You know, him and I just hung up. He was telling me about all the people he's helped explode their land businesses. So.
Chris is the man. I know Mr. Arnold. He gives
Hi.
good. He gives very good phone, and he's a great coach.
You got to get good phone.
We have we. Let me ask you. And what I just said with John, that is so. You can't fake that, guys. That's exactly what I do. I challenge myself to interact, to get into a few direct conversations every day with people, and I'll say, I'd like to do business today. Can I ask you? And then I go into the step we call an agenda. And I'll say, can I ask you just a couple questions? And you ask me a few, and let me see if we can do a deal today. And if not, tell me to get lost. Hang up the phone. It's all right. Boom. I got a shot here. Okay. I've got a chance. I think we've lost that skill of direct selling. Is that what they used to call it, Brent? Direct selling
Yeah,
101?
direct sales, direct sales. You know, Claude, if anybody that doesn't know you, one of my favorite things about working with you and joining your calls is just all the role play. I think role play, role play, role play. I think we should be role playing every single day. I'm curious. I don't know how long you have today, but would you have time to role play a big objection that some of us are getting?
Oh, I don't know. I hate objections. Oh,
I can't wait to tell you about an objection I got the other day.
And Chris Arnold, we have to do the I'll think about it, or I have to talk to my wife. Are there any other objections we get that we can
Yeah,
we're
I
not
want to
able?
hear like who's got an objection they got hit with on the phone the other day? And like, this is let's talk about phone. Like, anybody have an objection? They're just like, oh, what do I do with that?
What's your objection, Brent? The one you were talking about.
Well, this one was actually someone coming into the land sharks. So I don't know if it's relevant for land.
Sure.
But he hit me at the end with, well, I just got a divorce and my wife pulled a bunch of stuff and I might be doing time soon. And I was like, what the heck? How do I overcome that objection? I said, okay, brother, maybe it's not the right time. Click, hung up on.
Oh my God.
Wow, there's no light at the
Wasn't exactly like that, but I was like, gosh, I wish I could have gotten this in the first 3 minutes.
end of this
Yeah,
tunnel.
the guy is landlocked. He's landlocked.
The first thing that would come to me is qualification. Am I
That's
ever
funny.
going to do business with a guy who's incarcerated, has no credit, no money? When do we want to talk about money or qualify
Well, that's
for?
a good thing when they're selling you a piece of land. I've actually sent attorneys to prisons in Canyon City. I had an attorney go in that prison and get a bunch of probate work signed. So that's actually not a bad thing when they're selling you a piece of real estate.
That's beautiful. See, I didn't think of it. I thought he wanted to sign up for your program. He actually
You're
had
right. You're
pretty good
right.
skill.
You're right. That it was a land. It was someone interested in the Land Sharks program.
Okay. But if
He
he had
wasn't selling.
property for sale, how could you turn that into a pot? Hey, sir, you know what? You've had hard times. We've all had that little bonding and rapport. Okay. And said, so, you're going to go in. How long are you going in? I hope just a little while. Oh, 2 years. I'll tell you what, maybe you'll get out in one. And wouldn't it be great if you came out and you had this money already in a money market fund, growing interest, so you could get a fresh start on life? How do you feel about that, sir?
Yeah, that'd be better than having this piece of land.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, what's the best price you can give me on that land? I know it's worth 100,000. What would you take today, all cash, so you can have a fresh start when you get out?
Well, I don't have a lot of time. I mean, I go in about 3 days, maybe maybe a week. You're wanting to know money. I mean, I'd be happy if I can get about 20 grand before I had to go in, because I can think of a
that your
lot of
best
things to do.
price? Is that your best price?
If you can get me 20 grand before I go in, so I can have a little fun before I have to go and sit in the penitentiary for 3 years, I think we can
I'll
talk
tell
some
you
business.
what, I'll tell you what. If we can do a contract today, I'll send you a DocuSign, a contract today. I'll give it to my attorney and he'll proceed. I can't guarantee the 20,000 in 3 days, but I'll tell you what, you have an attorney, don't you? Somebody who represents or a family member you trust?
Well, there is Bill down the street. He was disbarred a few years ago. He might be able to help me a little bit.
I'll tell you what, we'll do a contract today. If you can get, could you get me that DocuSign back before 3:30 today? I'll call my attorney, I'll open escrow, and we'll stay in communication, and we will fulfill this contract in the next 30 to 45 days if you can get me back that agreement today.
Well, I can definitely get it back to you in the next 5 minutes, but I'm a little short on cash right now. Is there anything you can do today or tomorrow? Because again, I'm in what, 72 hours.
Okay. What do you need? 100, 200 bucks?
I mean, I was thinking like 1,000. I mean, it's I'm in Ohio. It's pretty expensive to party down out here.
Okay. Off the role play, I would do that if I did my due diligence and I knew it was free and clear. There was no liens on the pro, could I get a pre-title search on the thing? So I don't want to give $1,000 to a con. Maybe he doesn't even own the property, right?
That's what we got to be careful with land right now. The scam's been huge.
Yeah. But there's always a solution. If you the thing I love about it is, in my gut system, we cut out all the howdy doodies. Hi, how are you today? Just reaching out. Oh, and we go right to the heart of it. Would you like to do business today?
And that's what I love about it as I'm reading this book, because I know Jen's helped a lot of you guys as far as with sales, but she's big on the rapport thing, huge on it. I was never good at that.
I would, neither was I, but you know what? You do get good if you understand the science and the art, sales, persuasion, influence, convincing another person. How come some people are so great at it? We all want that thing called freedom. How do you get freedom? You give good phone. And how do you get good at sales? You got to understand the logic, the science behind it. Yesterday, I did on a group call with my mentees. We spent an hour on Cialdini, the principles of persuasion, scarcity, reciprocity, authority, social proof, consecutive, being consistent. What else is missing? Likability and trust. And if you inc that is the book, and I fitted a lot of these common sense. Psychological triggers into my system. It's a question-based system. So I learn to ask questions and get information while I'm nurturing the prospect. And the beautiful, there's something really magical when you can get into a conversation with a prospect, they turn into the salesperson. They start justifying to you why they're selling it, why they ask for, they start selling you. Okay, the rejection rate in some for so many salespeople. How fast when we get interrupted at dinner? How fast do we say, hey, take me off your list, click, call me in 2 weeks? How fast do we reject those cold calls at night during our meatloaf dinner? Real fast, right? Real fast. So we have to approach people in a different way. I'll call up back to those pattern interrupts. I'll call up people. Hi, John, Claude Diamond here. Man, I'm sorry it took me so long to get hold of you, get back to you. I'm so busy here. I've got your phone number in front of me here, John. Why am I calling? Come on, John. John, why am I calling you today? This isn't about real estate, is it?
There we go.
Boom. I will call up and sound different and act different, and I will utilize all those different strategies from Cialdini and from a lot of other people, Pavlov, Milton Erickson, the father of conversational hypnosis. I incorporated all this. I did a lot of research and a lot of practice, and I found out there are reasons why some people make unbelievable amounts of money. Okay, but compared to everybody else who's just working so hard and knocking on doors and making countless phone calls, and we can work smarter with less prospects. Imagine that, huh? I only speak to a few new pro. I do my training every day. Here's my day. In the morning, I do 5 to 8 training sessions, and then I usually speak to anywhere between, I'd say, 3 to 8 new prospects a day. Follow-ups, cold calls, warm schedule calls, or people I attracted. I have a system in place. Don't we love, and my feeling is, aren't warm calls better than cold calling all day? I can do
Yeah.
cold calls, but warm calls, aren't they better? Don't we love the warm call? Don't you love when a prospect calls you back? You know, that's the key. So you got to have a system of converting that cold call, that prospect, into a warm, friendly conversational call, and making offers, right? I make offers on every phone call all the time. And I even tell people, it's okay to say no. But this is your problem. This is the deal. You want to sell this property. You want to buy it. What do you need from me in order to do business today? Tell me a little bit of why are you even selling? Chris Arnold, why are you selling this property, Chris?
You know what? We haven't done anything with it in a long time. It's just sitting there.
Oh, how long have you had it, buddy?
20 years?
Keep it another 20. It's gone. It's only going to go up in value. You don't really want to sell it to me today, do you?
Nice. Pushing me away. Love
Push
it.
it away. Pushing you away. What does that force Chris to do? Another 30 seconds, Chris. Chris, why don't you keep it another 30 years, right? It's a good piece of property. You're not paying any taxes or anything on it, are you?
I am every year.
Oh, well, I mean, if you sold it now, all you'd get would be a lovely check. You don't want that, right?
Yeah, what's the check? How much for?
You know, oh, thank you for asking. Let me,
Now
you're
we're in.
and then I qualify him. Are you the owner? What do we want to know when we qualify someone? And Martin, I see your hand up. I'll get to you in a second. When we qualify somebody about a deal, what is it we really want to know up front?
Like
Are
they're a
you the
suspect.
decision maker?
Right? You know, motivation. Gee, Chris.
Motivation, timeline.
Yeah, timeline. Why? I see you wouldn't want to close it in the next 30 days, right, Chris? And get that nice check so you can take your wife to a Grand Canyon. I mean,
Yeah, I mean, I would if the price is right. Now we're in a whole different conversation right now.
now we're in the kill zone.
Yep, you moved me over.
We're in the kill zone. Now we're here. You know, we're right in there right away. And we use reverse psychology, redirection, I call it. Chris, you sure you want to have you, any of you guys, raise show of hands. Have you ever met a salesperson who told you why you shouldn't sell the land or shouldn't do the deal? Why do I do that? Am I crazy, Claude? Why do I do that? Take a guess. What happens when someone pushes us away or reject it? What's human
They
nature?
wanted more.
They wanted more. Who said? John said that. Yes, they wanted more. We go to the store because we want to buy something. We got a coupon or something like that. And they say, sorry, we're sold out. What's our reaction, John?
Darn.
Darn,
We were
you
gonna get
got.
more.
My son, we just got him a new car. You know, he wanted this Audi really bad. He found one dealership with this one car, Audi 5 or whatever. He had one car left. Who's got the strongest selling position? The dealership, right? I mean, I don't know if 15 more cars are coming next week. Oh, we got this one car. I got people coming in all the time and everything. It's a great car. It's a safe car. And we have a special credit, a $14,000 rebate on it. It's a hybrid. True, by the way. Sometimes when you take things away from the prospect, they want it even more. Remember that. Martin, you had your hand up there. I'm sorry.
How you deal with it. So I in terms of the qualifying, I think I do pretty good there. Where I struggle is I feel like in giving them a low offer, I'm gonna break rapport. So I've built this friendly conversation. And so that's the, and so sometimes I'll chicken out and get put myself into follow-up pal, which is like, well, let me see what I can do. Let me take a look at this again. I'll get back with you. Or like, oh, I'll give you a call back tomorrow. So when I know that, like, I have to drop